Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1830, Use Solver. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Haizen. Haizen is trying to arrange transport for a number of employees, anywhere from one employee to 500 employees. And here's what's available to him. He can rent a car for $200 with a capacity of 8. He can rent a microbus for $230 with a capacity of 14. And he can rent a minibus for $400 with a capacity of 26. And he wants a formula to figure out the right number of cars, microbuses, and minibuses. All right, now let's just pause for a second while I set this up. First thing I want to do is I want to build a table here from 1 to 500 so I can see every possible case. I select this one, go to the Fill Series. We're going to fill in columns from 1 to 500. Click OK, and there's our numbers. All right, now, as Haizen said, this is easy for the first 8 people. We get one car. And then for people 9 through 14, you get one microbus. And then for the number of people 15 through 26, one minibus. Ah, but these 27 is interesting. 27, you would think you might get one minibus and one car, but that is more expensive than two microbuses, all right? So it's complicated. Now, let's build a quick formula here to figure out the total capacity that we've arranged and the total cost. So H1 car times H1 car over here, I'll press F4, plus microbus times microbus over here, press F4, plus minibus times microbus over here, press F4. That figures out our capacity. During the pause, I created a similar formula there for cost and filled in all the blanks with zeros. We'll double click to shoot this down. All right, and my initial reaction is I need to figure out how this data is working, right? And so I was just going to do it just horrible brute force method. And so for 27 people, if we tried one minibus and one car, we've spent $600. But if we tried two microbuses and no minibuses, $460, clearly that's cheaper. And hey, by the way, that holds 28 people, so that means all of the answers down to 28 are going to be exactly the same. So I built a little set of formulas here that will copy the answer above straight down, because I don't have to solve all 500 of these problems. I only have to solve when this number here is not enough to cover the number of people I have. In fact, I can set up conditional formatting, Alt-O-D, new rule, use a formula, and that formula is going to be based on cell E29. Anytime that equal E29 is less than what is in A29, then we will format that in red. Click OK, click OK, click OK, and we'll copy that down. All right, so here we need to come up with some new solution for 29 people. But I realized that this brute force method is just going to be horrible. So I'm going to insert a second sheet and set up something called Solver. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Here I am on sheet 2. I've built this model where I'm trying to solve for 29 employees. Here's the quantities of cars, microbus, and minibus, and it'll calculate the capacity and cost. And I'm going to use an add-in that's been around in Excel for a long time called Solver. Go out to your Data tab and look on the right-hand side. If you don't see Solver there, then it's not enabled on your computer, but it's easy to enable. Alt-T-I. T-I will open the add-ins, and you choose Solver add-in. Click OK. All right, see, we now have a Solver out here on the right-hand side. We're going to set up a new solver parameters. We're going to set F7, the total cost, to the min by changing these three cells here. All right, but there's some constraints. First constraint is that this cell reference, this capacity here, has to be greater than or equal to the 29. Click OK. Now, the very first time I did this, earlier today, it quickly solved this, but it solved it by saying that we needed some fractional number of minibuses, and that's not the way it works. You can't have a fractional number of minibuses. So we're going to add some new constraints that says that this cell reference, the number of cars, must be an integer. It can't be a fractional number of cars. And then the number of microbuses must be an integer. And then finally, the number of minibuses must be an integer. Now, at this point, this is the last constraint, so I click OK instead of Add. So there are my constraints. GRG nonlinear is probably the slowest solver, but it works more often than not. All right, so I always use that method. And then we click Solve. You can watch down here in the lower left-hand corner as it's running what it's trying to do, but it comes up with one car and one minibus is the answer with $600. Click OK. And what's interesting is that must be the right answer for all of the answers from 29 up through 34. Okay, so I'm still going to do a little bit of manual effort here. I'm going to go back to sheet 1, find 29, which is the first place where we have something in red over here, and say that we need 101, and we have a cost of $600. And sure enough, that's good all the way down until we get to row 35. So back here, 35, solver. All of the parameters are still there. I just have to click solve. Click OK, and now it's 0, 1, and 1, and that will get us good up until row 40. I'm going to pause. All right, at this point, you know, I'm ready to send this back, but Haizen asked for a formula, and so I'm afraid that he has thousands of rows, and this really isn't going to be a good way. If he has thousands of rows, then we just want to do a VLOOKUP into this table, but we have to finish populating this table, which at this rate is going to be mind-numbingly boring. All right, because you know you would copy those values over and then do 41. So I want to see what would happen if I recorded a macro that would handle the solver part. So I'm going to do, first off, this is XLSX, which is the one horrible Excel format that does not allow macros. How silly is that? So we have to do File, Save As, and we're going to save it not with an XLS format, but with XLSM, or XLSB, either one of those is macro enabled, so we'll click Save. All right, so now we're allowed to have macros. Also, if you've never used macros before, Alt-T-M-S, and make sure that you're not set up there on that top one. The second one is fine, disable all macros with notification, but don't use the top one because then you won't be allowed to use macros. All right, so out here on the View tab, Macros, Record a Macro, and just, I'll call it Run Solver once. Let's see, Control, I'm going to put Shift S in there, Control Shift S for Solve, Store Macro in this workbook, click OK. And now I've already keyed 41 in here. I come out to the Data tab, Solver, click Solve, click OK, click Stop Recording, and let's go look at that code and see what happens. So do Alt F11 to get to VBA, double click on Modules, double click on Module 1. And sure enough, they are doing things. It is recording code. Isn't this awesome? And all of this stuff here, the solver OK, since that's not changing, we just have to do solver solve over and over and over again. This is going to be really good. All right, another pause there while I went through and recorded the answer for 41. Next thing we have to solve is 43. So Alt here, Alt F11, Run Solver once. We click Run. And we get compile error sub or function not defined. All right, now I have to thank John Peltier. He has a great website that documents what the problem is here. We have to go to Tools, References, and add a reference to Solver. This references includes all open VBA projects, so we add that reference to Solver. And now when we run this macro, so we're trying to run for 43, that one simple change allows it to work. You see it's trying to solve the problem down here. But we're getting the OK message. All right, I'm going to pause again while I record this answer for 43. OK, great, Pat. I'm back. Control-Shift-S to run the next one. And boy, it'd be nice if we could get rid of this OK so we didn't have to click OK. We could actually have it in some sort of a loop. Hang on a second. See, now in the background here, after each time that I run Solver, I come back and I key in the right answers and then look for the next spot where the we don't have enough and we'll run solver for 55. And so I kind of have this feeling of what I'm doing manually, and it'd be nice if we could write VBA that would do all of those steps. For example, it would record the 0, 2, and 1 in the right spot and then increment this by 1 and add it into cell C1. Okay, here's a quick bit of code that I knocked out. We're working with two different worksheets, sheet 1 and sheet 2, so I declare those as worksheets. Dim, WS1 is worksheet, dim, WS2 is worksheet. Set WS1 equal to worksheet sheet 1, and then WS2 is equal to sheet 2. This is our recorded code, solver.solve. And then I'm going to figure out which row we're writing to. So if we're working on employee number 55, that's going to be written to employee or row number 56, because I have one row of headings back here on sheet 1. And then WS1 on sheet 1, go to which row, column 2, that's column B, one row, three columns wide, is going to be equal to the value from row 4, column 1, row 5, column 1, row 6, column 1. So right there, that is a single line of code with space underscores, those are continuation characters at the end. And then figure out which to solve for next. So when we solve for 55, this number here might be 60, and so we know that everything from 55 to 60 is the same value, and we will want this to be, this 60 to be copied up here as 61. So WS2 cells row 1, column 3 is equal to row 7, column 5, dot value plus 1. All right, and then we still have the problem that we have to answer OK every time that we run solver.solve. But at John Peltier's site, I learned that if I made this into a function, x is equal to solver solve, and in parentheses, this user finish here, say true, means that it will not show us the OK dialog box, or the dialog box where we have to hit OK. All right, so this is kind of exciting now, because it's about to go solve this one, log the answers for me, and then be ready to run the next one. So I'm just anywhere in here, I'll click OK. I see that it's down here trying to do its thing. It came up with an answer of 040, which will handle us for employees up to 56, and then it already put the right answer in here of 57. Let's go check and make sure that it put the right answers back here, 040. So that's the answer for employees 55 and 56. It's really kind of funny how sometimes we get a big, huge string, and sometimes it's just a couple before the answer changes. But sure enough, row 50 or 57 employees is where it changes again. All right. I could keep hitting Control-Shift-Fs to have it solve one at a time, but I'm still going to have to be here through lunch as I work on getting this all the way up to 500. So we'll come back to our code, and right down here at the end, we're going to say, if WS2.cells 7, 5.value is greater than 500, then exit sub. Just go ahead and finish. Otherwise, we're going to go to run again. End if. And run again is just a label that we're going to have up here. Put an a colon after it, and it says that this will just go ahead and run again. So it's going to solve one, log the answers, increment the value, and then run again. And it's going to keep doing it until we get to 500. All right, so right now, November 27th, it's 11:02 a.m. I'm going to let this start to run, Control Shift S. I see down here that it is working on something, and then it ups this number from 61 to 67 to 69 and so on. So it's going to be running for a while. Again, I'll pause the video. Okay, there we are, 11:07. It took about 5 or 6 minutes, and we've gotten all the way up where it has solved for every possible combination of from one passenger up through 500 passengers. We know what the answer is. Now, I'm just curious if there's any sort of a pattern here. So I'm going to let Excel create a chart for me of just the car, microbus, and minibus. Make sure we're at the top there. See what the recommended chart is. I think it has to be a stacked bar chart. So that's interesting with a line chart. I'm not going to go with any of those. I want to see a stacked column chart. Stacked column chart, actually. So right here, stacked column. Click OK. I don't see any clear trends there. Maybe there's a better way to do this to figure out what the trend is. And is there math that could minimize this? That's a great question. I didn't pay enough attention in math class to know the answer to that. Some of you watching this on YouTube may say, hey, there's better math. But the dangerous or good thing or dangerous thing, is that using solver and a little bit of macro code, I was able to just brute force run through all 500 possibilities and come up with the correct answers. Now, what do I do if I'm Haizen? What is my future way to use this? If I have thousands of different possibilities, I have to solve them all at once, I'm going to do a VLOOKUP into this table. All right. But if it's a tool, especially where if the cost changes daily, and for each one I have to solve it, well then I'm probably just going to want a macro that will be run solver once. Okay, so here, let's make this run solver all, and then I'm going to copy that code. I'm just going to select from here all the way down to the bottom, Control C, and run solver once. And let's see, I don't even know if we have to record the answers or not. I'm not going to have it increment, I'm not going to have any of this down there. So this little macro now will run solver one time, and would just be a great tool to use on a go forward basis to solve one at a time. So I'm going to insert a little shape here, rounded shape, and we will add a text box, solve for cell C1. Let's do a little align center, align right, actually hit one extra return there, increase the size, and then finally right click, assign macro, and that's going to be called run solver once. And so, you know, we have a new cost. So today the cost of a car is $195, the cost of the microbus is $235, minibus is still $400, and we have to get 42 passengers solve for cell C1. That'll go out and run solver once, 030. So now we have this great little tool where we're good to go. That's if we're allowed to do one at a time. If we really need a formula, well then you're going to have to update these costs and have a second button here. I'm going to control click this, control drag, and this will be solve entire table. We'll change the macro here and the colors. So back on format, choose a different color, and right click, assign macro, run solver all, click OK. Actually, I'm going to go back to that code and make sure that we start out with that ws2.cells1,3.value is equal to 1, and also ws1.cells row 3, 2.resize 499,3.formula R1C1 is equal to equal R-1 column. That resets everything to be the value just above. Alright, so this is actually run solver all. Alright, so we have two different buttons there, one to just solve a single time, one to solve the entire table, and then our VLOOKUPs would work. All right, so we covered an awful lot in this video. Started out with installing solver, setting up solver to run once, using VBA to run the existing solver over and over and over again, how to use VBA to log the results, using VBA to run all possible, the entire universe of possibilities, so that way we have a table of all of the answers already calculated. Again, I want to refer you out to John Peltier's site, peltiertech.com/excel/solvervba.html. He has great VBA examples there. If you need to use solver, like I was able to run it first, which loads solver. If you want VBA to run it the first time, you have to look at the code out there. So this is, unfortunately, the best answer that I have is pre-building this table and then using VLOOKUPs based on the number of passengers to get the correct answers. Probably much more convoluted than what Haizen was looking for. If you know a better way to do this, you know, I'm thinking, is there matrix multiplication? Is there a way to solve simultaneous equations? Is there some other way to solve this without the brute force method of solver? Please let me know down in the YouTube comments right down there. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.